5 minutes at Pizza V again, and yeah, I have a new video format for you guys. Sorry if this is not perfect, the character is just temporary, but I found a new way to actually make videos and talking at the same time without me copy and pasting the same character over and over again. This is just temporary, this is not the character that it's gonna be in the future videos. But hey, at least it's an animation and this is way better than, yeah, putting the character over and over and whenever. I don't know, it's tiring. Okay. So, episode 9 of Sakura and the Clear Card, Sakura and the Thrilling Visit to the Aquarium. So the episode starts with Sakura, Yue and Kero talking about the cards she has gotten so far. But however, nothing that I can detect still happens. So what's going on? Yue doesn't know, Kero doesn't know, they don't feel the cards, they don't feel anything. They discuss about that, and furthermore, the dreams she has been having with a mysterious person. But nothing to be explored yet. Come on, we're just on episode 9. Nothing more. Kero bears interrupts them, saying that Sakura has to go because she has an important date today. She's going to visit the aquarium with Shouran. Kat is waiting for her at the bus station and she's wearing a cute ballerina outfit, sort of like. Plus, she has brought over food with her that her dad made. And here's the thing, are they allowed to even bring food to other places without them being in trouble? Because that's not allowed here. So, just wondering. This part is kinda cute because when Sakura offers the ticket to Shouran, she says, oh yeah, you can have this, it was from my dad and one of his school workers, students, that offer. And the kid that's passing by them, mom, they're red. Oh, they must like each other. They got even more red, which is cute. They're talking about fishes and walking around and look at this fish and yeah, Marilyn sends a message. Take action. That's what she said, but yeah. You know, one thing that impressed me with Shouran was the fact that when there were a couple of tourists looking at the billboard and saying, oh, it's the penguin performance. Just like when they, not with Shouran, but when Sakura actually captured the watery card. I think it was the fourth episode, I'm not entirely sure. But I remember it was one of the few first episodes. Yeah, they were performing the same way and Sakura comments that, hey Shouran, did you know that this is where I got the watery card? He didn't know that, but he nodded. But furthermore, what I was going to say, Shouran impressed me when he invited the tourists to go with them because they were speaking in English and his accent was rather good. Very good. And Sakura impressed by what he just did. And hey, they are cute. And Shouran blushes because Sakura does not understand what they said. That's something interesting, right? After the penguin performance, they decide to go and have a break to actually eat at the cafeteria or restaurant or whatever you want to call it. But again, Toya is there and he doesn't like Shouran yet. But Sakura interrupts and says, hey, would you like to drink a strawberry milkshake with me? Because yeah, we have to order something. And Toya, yeah, sure, coming right up. But they should stop glaring at that. Hey big bro, you need to deal with it. She chose him and you know it, you just don't like your little sister has someone she likes. But you know, how big brothers can be. Sharon decides to take the advice from Maylin and actually take a step and say something to Sakura. Would you like to... And the glass breaks, traps Sakura, just like the watery card trapped the lady from the penguins from the series before. But hey, at least this time Sakura was saved by Toya and Sharon. Sharon was the one that got her back, and Toya just took the emergency thingy button. And what happened to the fish? What happens to the fish if the fish go to the other way? I mean, to the sewers. I mean, no. I mean, fishy, fishy, fishy. Why are they there? And the glass breaks. Yeah. Even though Toya does not like it, he saved her. So this first part ends with the lunchbox that her dad made being all soggy. When Sakura returns home, she has to tell Tomoyo right away. It happened like before. So, as you know, they have to go there and capture the card. And Tomoyo knows exactly what to do. Record everything. FYI, if you didn't saw the Sakura Card Captor first series, you would have the same feeling as the characters did in the anime, which is huge deja vu, especially because she is wearing almost the same costume, just with shorter pointy hat. But it's a huge sense of deja vu for those who saw it. I personally had a huge sense of deja vu. However, the only thing that is different is the fact that Sharon is with them. And the card was the watery card. If you've never seen the series, go watch it. I recommend it. Sharon wonders if that's okay for sneaking in with the night guard there, but yeah, they are used to it. Don't worry, Sharon, you'll get used to it if you come along with us. But they are talking, so they are heard by a security guard that is doing the shift over there. But luckily, Sakura has the illicit card, so they got invisible. I still call it the invisible cloak from Harry Potter, but it's okay. Sakura knows what to do, so just leave everything to her. She has dealt with this many, many times. Anyways, when Sakura reaches the tank, they're like, "This looks so much like the watery card. I can't believe it, but feels different at the same time because I can't feel the card. It's not a cloak card." The end. It's the ace of water. So it's tarot cards if we go look at them carefully. However, this time Sakura is having trouble capturing it because nothing seems to work. So she decides to run away from it until that thing breaks the glass on the roof. So she got out using flight. When they go outside, Sharon asks Keroveras what was the strategy last time they used. He thinks about it. Kero, there is nothing much to think about it. It was watery. You froze it, remember? Call Elsa. No, this time. Sharon calls the ice god and freezes it. Although I thought he would get that card because he was the one that froze it. No, she secures it and got Spiral. Why wouldn't they both get the card together? Strange. I thought he would get one at least, but okay. I am not gonna be the judge of that. Tomoyo shows up shortly after, very happy that she decided to film everything on air. Because guess what? She has a drone, so she captured everything. Anyway, this is not a big review. I think I put every detail there. I mean, not every detail. So if you want to see all details, I think it's best for you to watch the anime itself, because there are a few things that I didn't say. But yeah, I hope though this was still better than normal. And I'm sorry about my voice. I'm getting sick again because everyone in the house is getting sick, so I got sick. So anyway, thanks a lot for watching, guys. What did you think about the episode? Did you watch it? I watched it after... I watched it before I watched Dragon Ball Super. Yeah, I watched both animes. I can only handle one anime at a time. So, since I've been watching Super since the beginning, more or less, I'm keeping up with those. So yeah, what did you think about the episode? Do you like my reviews like this? Should I do more? I'm gonna change my character to my personal one, because I think I can manage this somehow. So yeah, like always, guys, thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you guys on my next drawing video, anime review, comic dub, whatever it has to be, it will have to be. So, like always, guys, and once again, thanks a lot for watching. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, if you haven't already, share with people that might enjoy this kind of content, and I will be seeing you on my next episode. And like always, till next time, take care, bye bye.